Dig up any information on the mission, Lyra?
I did, and I now understand why High Command wanted to hide it. We're headed to an Ardat Yakshi monastery.
Ardat Yakshi? Like Morinth?
Morinth chose to be a killer. These Ardat Yakshi isolated themselves to avoid that. But it doesn't mean they're harmless. Their urge to feed can be powerful. That's why High Command sent in commandos to investigate the monastery's distress signal.
That is less than encouraging. What were the commando's orders?
If there was a chance the Ardat Yakshi could break loose, the commandos were to purge the monastery.
Purge? You mean destroy?
They would have brought heavy explosives with them, yes.
Morinth was dangerous, but are the Ardat Yakshi this big of a threat?
Morinth was just hitting her stride. Ardat Yakshi who kill leave behind astronomical body counts. It's why they can never be free, and why they're such a great source of shame to the Asari. That's why High Command won't rest until this place is destroyed. They'd never risk a single Ardat Yakshi getting loose.
We don't need something that dangerous running around during a war. We locate the commandos, then finish the job.
As you wish. Though I'd like to know exactly who sent the distress call.
We'll find out soon enough.
Indicating recent use.
Elevator disabled. To prevent entry or escape, I wonder.
That vocalization exceeds Asari vocal cord range. As do those.
What was that?
Stay sharp. I heard something.
That was my fault, sorry. This was the commando's captain. It seems they gave their lives fighting the Reapers.
This monastery's out of the way. What do the Reapers want with Ardat Yakshi? Anything useful?
A floor plan marked with a nav point location for a bomb. It's planted inside the monastery's great hall.
So the commandos started the purge after all.
This place is a lost cause if it's already crawling with Reapers. Let's get to the great hall and set off that bomb.
Thank you. Very good. I almost didn't hear you.
Samara.
It has been some time, Shepard. You are a most welcome sight. The corruption here runs deep.
I assume you're here on your own, Justicar. Perhaps for something special?
You are correct. Two of my daughters live here, and I have come for them. Unfortunately, the Reapers had already infested this place by the time I arrived.
You met me hunting down your other Ardat Yakshi daughter. Are these ones just as dangerous?
Falair and Rila have followed the monastery's rules ever since they arrived. They've shown no inclination toward violence.
And you're here to save them?
They are my responsibility. And it's one that cannot be abandoned, even as our galaxy crumbles.
Find your daughters fast. I'm setting off a bomb the commandos brought here.
The Justicar Code demands I discover what happened to my children in this monastery. I cannot ignore it. We're out of time. We'll meet again. I will draw these creatures off.
Wait! Let's go.
My name is Tashia Pore. I'm wounded. Bad. Give this to my bondmate, Weshra. Asked her to go to the Citadel and tell Weshra I love her. Tell her... Sorry we fought. I was an idiot. Didn't mean any of it, Weshra. Want you to have everything of mine, okay? Love you. I love you so. My name is Tashia. Worry.
This was likely the Reaper's initial attack site.
Think the monastery got any warning?
Few signs of resistance. I'd say very little warning.
Got it. Got it. What was that?
Common to banshees are the corrupted Asari often found leading a Reaper strike force. The Reapers create them specifically from Asari with active or latent predispositions to becoming Ardat Yakshi, a rare neurological condition that enhances the Asari's biotic power while causing the immediate death.
Reaper's done.
Mother, you came.
As soon as I was able. Shepard, this is Falaire, my youngest. She and her sister Rila are Ardat Yakshi. They have
Mother,
been...
they have Rila.
What?
I saw some of those creatures take her into the Great Hall. I've been trying to get there.
What are the Reapers doing here?
Harvesting us. They're turning us into... into those... monsters. Please. You can't let that happen to Rila.
The Asari thought the Ardat Yakshi were to blame for the attack.
This is our home. Most of us are grateful to be here. The monastery is a place Ardat Yakshi can achieve peace.
Falaire speaks truthfully, Shepard. I vouch for her words with pride.
There's a bomb in the Great Hall. We're setting it off, so find your sister quickly.
Bomb? But I thought you came to rescue us.
I'm here because this place is a liability.
A liability? My friends have been killed, turned into...
Falaire, we did not come to argue.
No, you came to destroy us! Falaire!
The Great Hall. She's looking for Rila.
Look for that bomb.
I doubt we'll miss it.
You'd need a crowbar to pry those doors open. This place was beautiful before the Reapers came.
Thank you.
Another Asari commando, also deceased.
Falaire and her sister may be the only survivors.
Yes. I was unsure if it was appropriate to broach the subject.
Thank you, Edie. But don't spare my feelings. It's better to know.
Intact.
So does Falaire.
Look! She's still alive!
I know, but I am afraid Rila is not well.
Rila's not one of them yet. She can't be. She just needs to wake up. Why did she do that?
Because they've begun to turn her into one of the Reaper's creatures.
I'm sorry. Can we set off that bomb?
The explosives require a detonator.
Commandos would have had one. We've got to find it. Later.
Thank you. last one.
For now, let's get back to that bomb.
Valair, go! Take the elevator!
Rila, what are you doing?
It's too late for me. There are hundreds coming. Just go!
Move!
No! Rila!
I love you.
Rila! Rila, there wasn't even time to say goodbye.
Few can break the Reaper's hold. Rila's will was extraordinary, as was her love for you.
We left her to die.
Rila made her choice, and it has reminded me of what is truly important. Why I swore I'd lay down my life.
What is that?
Valair, the code demands an Ardat Yakshi cannot live outside a monastery that no longer exists.
What are you doing?
I'm sorry, Shepard. By the Justicar's code, there is only one way to save Valair.
Mother, no!
My daughters, you were all so much stronger than I believed. Let go.
What are you doing?
Fulfilling the code.
By throwing your life away?
I won't kill my last daughter.
You won't have to.
Valair?
I'll stay here. Home. No matter what's become of it.
Without a proper monastery,
I could have left any time. I don't need a building to honor my own code. And if the Reapers return, they won't take me alive. I promise.
Then, the code permits you to stay, as you are. Once this war is over, and if I am able, I will visit, as a Justicar should.
I meant it when I said the galaxy needs you against the Reapers.
You were right. It's past time I joined your battle. I'll fight in your armies, Shepard, once I speak with Valair.
I'll be waiting.
Not for long. Thank you, my friend.
Everything's taken care of down here. Bring in the shuttle.
Right, Commander. I'll just follow the smoke.
I read your report, Commander. We had no idea the situation had deteriorated so quickly.
That's why I set off the bomb. There were no Ardat Yakshi left.
May the Ardat Yakshi find rest. What the Reapers did to them was monstrous. I had another team of commandos headed to the monastery who I can now formally transfer to Admiral Hackett's command. They'll serve you loyally, Commander. Farewell.
Commander, Admiral Hackett's available on Midcom.
Seemed popular for a while. They were fighting the collectors while the council sat and watched.
And now they're killing...
Commander, Dr. Chakwas sent word that she'd like to speak with you down in the medbay. The project received some new tech from the Asari government.
I'm glad they've decided to help the war effort.
Everybody has to fight now, no matter how pretty you are. I learned that the hard way.
Everybody was fighting the Rachni, trying to push them back through the relay. Finally, the Krogan were turned loose and stopped them.
I see.
But when the Krogan rebelled, we had to deploy the Genophage to stop them. Wasn't the only rebellion. 1,000 years later, the Geth revolted against the Quarians. That was a whole other war. Then along came the humans. My own people tangled with them for a while, and now, to top it all off, we've got the Reapers. What about you?
The Ouroboros fought the Densorin. The Andoromai conquered the Vandomar, and the Xatil turned against the Xa.
So, I guess nobody really ever gets their act together.
The Sinriel claimed to have found the path to eternal peace.
What happened?
The Dittaker preferred war. Wiped them out.
I hope you guys had alcohol.
Some of the crew seem shocked by the monstrosities we have encountered. They haven't seen what the Reapers could corrupt after 100 years. That was our war. Every battle conjured a new nightmare. This human holds such childish views of war. Your species has much to learn. Commander.
Samara is the kind of soldier we need in this war. Nothing gets in her way. I just hope I'm not in her way someday. That woman means business. Now it's a mutated Asari. The Reapers are just a giant nightmare factory that never ends. I can only imagine what the Reapers are doing to the Drell. Or the Hanar. Or the Vorcha. This could get a lot worse before it gets better. Later. It's a brilliant tactic, when you think about it.
But it's evil.
When has that ever mattered in war?
Yeah, but converting other life forms into Reapers? I can't wrap my head around that.
Makes sense to me. It ensures you never run out of cannon fodder. Eliminates any local resistance. And for every soldier you add, your enemy loses two. The one you converted, and his buddy on the other side who can't pull the trigger on a friend.
You sound like you admire them.
Same way I admire a virus or a thresher maw. They've adapted perfectly to their situation.
But the Reapers want to destroy us.
And I have no intention of letting them. But if you don't respect your enemy's capabilities, you're in for one nasty surprise after another.
Shepard, remember our agreement? We'd open a bottle of Cerise Ice Brandy every year, and it's my turn to buy.
But it hasn't been a year yet.
Yes, well, something tells me we won't have the chance a few months from now, so indulge my impatience.
You grab the glasses. I'll open the bottle.
And Jeff says, Jack, Jacqueline Subject Zero, sorry. But it's ma'am to me. I'd like to keep my Admiral Winky. Oh, Shepard, you know, I just realized. You've never called me by my first name.
Well, neither have you.
And I never will. You are Commander Shepard, hero of the Citadel, conqueror of the Collectors, savior of the galaxy. Using your first name just disrespects everyone you're fighting for, alive or gone.
That makes no sense.
Consider it a lady's prerogative, then. Come, let's have a toast.
To a woman I respect and admire. I'm lucky to have you with me, Doctor.
And to you. It's my great honor to share this journey with you, Commander. And good fortune to us all. I've learned my lesson this time. Even a Krogan couldn't match you drink for drink. So, Udina finally went over the edge. I never really liked the man. Now I know why. Hello, Commander.
I find using my biotics to toss someone across the room is a decent attention grabber.
Yes, but it's also a good way to draw enemy fire.
Well, you can handle yourself in a fight now, Lyra. I mean, not that your biotics weren't impressive the first time we met.
I have had my fair share of opportunities to use them these past few years.
Well, I'm glad you got through in one piece. Sounds like you have a few stories to tell.
Poor Rila. But I'm glad she set off that bomb, Shepard.
You're not upset the monastery was destroyed?
No, not after what I saw. I don't care that they were Ardat Yakshi. To be turned into such creatures, nobody deserves that. Hello again.
Yakshi? No.
I think that story would be perfect for you. The hidden dark side of the most beautiful race in the galaxy.
We have a huge Asari audience. If I do that story, I could lose them.
That seems a bit like pandering.
Ever seen how fast an e-democracy can abandon its allies?
No.
If I do my job, you won't.
I've always loved the M35 Mako. It's got heart, you know?
Ah, oh, come on! The M44 Hammerhead is vastly superior.
Come on, that thing's made of tissue paper. At least the Mako can take a few hits.
I'd hope so. That thing handles like a drunk rhino. No agility whatsoever.
More like a bull that can climb and climb for days.
It only climbs because of its stupid, vertically aligned mass effect fields. Jump or stick. No speed. No lateral movement.
Hey, with a cannon like that, who needs to move?
If you want that, why don't you just stick with the old M29 Grizzly?
Hey, I love that tank.
You would be one to love grizzly bears, Mr. Vega.
What? What's so funny?
Damn, I could really use something to shoot right now. Glad you talked Samara down.
I never thought I'd see her flinch from her duty.
I don't know. On one hand, that code's all she's had to live by for, God, centuries. Then the galaxy goes to hell. The old rules don't cut it anymore. I mean, we're cutting some corners, right?
A few.
Well, the Alliance can always court-martial us after we save the galaxy.
What are you doing, Edie?
Monitoring reports of proton storms and other space weather. With the Reapers attacking the comm buoy systems, critical warnings may be lost.
How bad are these storms?
If we are warned, not bad. If we are not warned, very bad.
Thanks for the info, Edie.
Hello, Shepard.